Today, I'm going to review the $6,500 PacoJet, a machine beloved by professional chefs for the last 30 years, against this $200 PacoJet clone, the Ninja Creamy. Now, you may have questions, like what is a PacoJet? How does it work? And why would I even want one in my kitchen? And if you already know the answers to those questions, then your question might be, at about 1/30th the price, can this machine even be close to as good as the PacoJet? In the rest of this video, I'm going to show you how these machines work, how you can use them in your kitchen. I'm going to try to explain why at $200, I believe this machine is a screaming deal, and I'm going to tell you how you can win one from our sponsors at Combustion Inc. Let's get started. The PacoJet was invented by the Swiss-born engineer Wilhelm Maurer, who was living in Brazil in the late 1980s. He was looking for a way to make soft-serve ice cream conveniently, and he used a drill press. And in fact, when we look at a PacoJet now, we'll see, in fact, it works a lot like a drill press. And the way it works is it takes frozen cylinders of, in this case, ice cream base, and a spinning blade to mill that frozen base into the soft, smooth consistency that we expect of ice cream. Maurer received a patent for his invention, and being more of an inventor than an entrepreneur, made the decision to sell his patent in 1988 to a group of Swiss investors who bought the rights to the patent, formed a company, PacoJet AG, around it, and commercialized it. Commercializing this invention into a product proved a bit more expensive than they might have expected. So they made the very reasonable decision to focus on selling this machine into the professional restaurant world rather than the domestic consumer world. And then in 2017, their patent expired. Now, they continue to sell this machine into the professional chef world at $6,500 today, but nothing has really changed about the machine since it was introduced commercially in 1993. With the patent expired, the Shark Ninja Corporation took a look at the technology and decided they were going to make an attempt at bringing it to the home consumer under the Ninja brand, and they've done that. PacoJet has not adjusted to the fact that they no longer have a monopoly on this technology. They're trading on their brand. They're trading on the reputation that they've earned over the years from chefs. The question is it really better than Ninja's execution at $200? And as we see when we look inside, I think the answer is not really. With the machines opened up, we can see their similarities and a few important differences. Now, both machines work in the same way. They take frozen canisters of sorbet, ice cream, even savory puree bases, and machine them down into the smooth mix that you want. The PacoJet canister holds slightly more, about 700 milliliters of volume, to the Ninja's 400 or so milliliters of volume. To do the milling, they use these stainless steel blades to cut and pulverize the frozen base into that smooth mixture. Both have two blunt stirring smashing blades. Both have two cutting blades. The PacoJet's blade is about 24% larger in diameter and has four cutting teeth across it, to Ninja's three, but in all of the important ways, these blades are functionally identical. For both machines, the canisters are loaded in and a blade both cuts and drives down through the frozen mixture to give us our final product. Now, in the case of the PacoJet, we have a single motor that does all of that work. In fact, the motor is almost comically oversized. It uses a belt drive to spin the blade at about 2200 RPMs, and then through a system of gearing on the shaft, it also uses another belt to advance the shaft down through the mixture at about 1 millimeter per second. And this means the PacoJet has no independent control over how fast the blade is spinning and also advancing. One thing the PacoJet does have that's unique is it also has an air compressor attached to this gearing system so that air is taken through a filter, pressurized into the headspace above the canister, whipping more air into the ice cream as the blade spins and cuts. Now that does create a fairly moussey texture that isn't appealing to everyone. So with this blue button, you can release the air pressure. And in many cases, I've known chefs to disconnect this entirely because they don't particularly like that much air whipped into their mixture. In the case of the Ninja, we have two motors. We have a large motor that does the job of spinning the blade somewhat slower at about 1700 RPMs. And interestingly, a separate motor that's responsible for driving the blade down through as it cuts. This gives the Ninja independent control over how fast the blade is spinning and advancing. And that can be pretty useful for things like adding mix-ins, pieces of M&Ms, for example, into your ice cream base. With a PacoJet, those pieces will be pulverized to a fairly fine consistency, whereas the Ninja is able to stir them in. Now, the PacoJet's motor is oversized, and that's advantageous in a commercial environment where the motor can run batch after batch after batch without overheating and having to shut down and cool off. The Ninja's motor, by contrast, is oversized. It isn't going to have the stamina to do canister after frozen canister after frozen canister without eventually getting to the point where it's too hot, trips a thermal fuse, and needs to cool down for a while before it can keep going. That's a fairly important difference in a commercial environment where this machine might get used constantly throughout service. But in a home environment, how often are you going to do 6, 7, 8 canisters back to back? Not very often. So I think that's a reasonable trade-off for Ninja to have made in terms of bringing this technology to the domestic environment. The PacoJet also pacotizes it about 30% faster. But while that difference sounds big, in practice it's not. It takes about 2 minutes for the PacoJet to do 40% more volume, to the Ninja Creamies taking about 2.5 minutes to do about 40% less volume. In practice, in a professional kitchen, that higher volume, that higher capacity, and the ability to do canister after canister after canister might be quite important. It might be worth the price difference. But in a domestic home kitchen, it's very unlikely that that's important. The smaller volume is about pint-sized, about the size of a conventional premium ice cream, and taking 2.5 minutes instead of 2 minutes is just not that material of a difference. It's still rather quick. Now, another difference simply comes down to usability. In the case of the PacoJet, for loading it, we take this silicone gasket, attach the blade. That attaches to the shaft, which can be a bit fiddly. The canister is loaded into the hopper, and then through a bayonet mechanism, we attach it. Not too bad. In contrast to the PacoJet, a lot more engineering effort was put into the loading of the canister. We have our beaker holder. The beaker nicely drops in and has some anti-spin features molded into the bottom. We attach the blade to this. The handle comes straight in, and then with just a rotation, it locks into place. Now that might seem like a fairly simple feature, but as somebody who engineers consumer products himself, making that work was a tremendous amount of engineering time. Other than their difference in capacities, another very basic difference between the PacoJet canister and the Ninja canister is their material. The PacoJet canister is visibly metal, and the Ninja canister is transparently plastic. That's convenient for letting me see what's inside, but in a professional environment, this metal is going to take quite a bit of abuse and be fine, whereas plastic canisters, when they get dropped, tend to crack and break. The durability and, frankly, ruggedness of a metal canister makes a lot of sense for the professional environment, which is what this machine's intended for. Whereas the cost effectiveness and, frankly, convenience of this plastic canister also makes sense for the market that Ninja's targeting, which is the home market. To really understand how these machines work, we really have to understand how ice cream and sorbets work and how we make them. Conventional ice cream machine takes an unfrozen base, whether ice cream or sorbet, and freezes it against the sides of the machine, scraping the ice crystals away as it goes. In contrast, a PacoJet or a Ninja Creamy takes a frozen canister of ice cream or sorbet base and mills it down into a fine mixture vertically. Air is one of the most important ingredients when we're making ice creams or sorbets. Without air, we'd have a frozen popsicle. Now, it's also one of the biggest differences between a conventional ice cream machine and a PacoJet or a Ninja Creamy. When we make ice cream or sorbet in a conventional ice cream machine, we're whipping air into it with each stir. That's one of the biggest differences between ice cream made in a conventional churning machine versus a PacoJet or a Ninja. There is more air in a conventional ice cream machine than there would be in a PacoJet and Ninja. It's different. Is it better? It depends on what you like. Personally, I tend to like the texture of the ice cream or sorbet base that we get out of a PacoJet or a Ninja. It melts a bit faster in the mouth. It tends to have a more intense flavor release. It's a little bit colder though, because we have less of that insulating air bubbles in our mix. For richer ice creams, really high fat ice creams, I probably prefer what we get out of a conventional ice cream machine, and it is noticeably different if you compare them side by side. You'll see that the ones made in the PacoJet or the Ninja Creamy melt much quicker. They have less air in them. That air helps insulate them from warming up too quickly. If I want a slow melting ice cream, which I might, a A churned ice cream is definitely going to do a better job of that than one made in a Paco Jet or a Ninja Creamy. But there's a trade-off. The faster an ice cream melts in your mouth, the more intense the flavor release tends to be. So if I want a very bright, forward flavor that pops in the mouth, I tend to get that from an ice cream prepared in a Paco Jet or a Ninja Creamy, more so than in a conventional ice cream machine. Conversely, if I want a flavor to linger and feel richer, especially if I have a higher fat ice cream, one prepared in a conventional churn style ice cream machine, it's gonna have that lingering flavor. It's gonna feel richer in the mouth. It's gonna feel a bit warmer in the mouth. They are differences that chefs notice. Does that make one better than the other? Not necessarily, but it does make them different. At the beginning of this video, I said there'd be a way for you to win one of these Ninja Creamies. Let me tell you how. This is a predictive thermometer and its kitchen timer that I'm making with my team at Combustion Inc. The thermometer is wireless and has 8 temperature sensors to measure the temperature inside and outside your food, at the center and at the surface, and nearly everywhere in between. It works together with this timer or a mobile app to not only tell you the temperature, but to also make a prediction of how long your food needs to cook, and importantly, how long it should rest for to end up perfectly done every time. Now, if you go to our website, combustion.inc, in the next 30 days and sign up for our SMS list, not only will you receive a discount when these begin shipping later this summer, but you'll also be eligible to win one of the 2 Ninja Creamies that we bought for making this video. I'll put a link to our website below. Now, back to our video. I'll admit to being skeptical that the Ninja Creamy was going to be a very good machine. This kind of quality engineering is not something I have previously associated with the Ninja brand, to be honest. But I've come away incredibly impressed. They've engineered a machine that's accessible for the home kitchen. It's a lot smaller. It weighs a fraction of the weight. It's 13 pounds versus 35 pounds. It will sit on your countertop and can fit under the cabinets that most people would have over their counters at home. And a lot more thought was put into making it very easy and simple to use than the somewhat brutish Paco Jet. Is this better? Is this worse? I think for a home kitchen, you have a different set of problems than a professional kitchen. The Paco Jet is designed for that professional environment and has never been translated into the home environment. Ninja has done, frankly, an impressive job of translating this technology and making it accessible for home cooks. I think their biggest challenge is convincing people why you should want this in the first place. And I hope I've convinced you that you want one of these. And at $200, I think it's kind of a screaming deal. You would think that for $6,500, the Paco Jet is the better machine. And for the professional kitchen, it is certainly more durable. On the other hand, the Ninja Creamy is $200. I can have 32 Ninja Creamies for the price of one Paco Jet, and that's a kind of durability in and upon itself.